So, as the title says, this will kind of be an early game domain guide. So, first off, we'll just look at in the very early game what domains to actually do. Because if we just take a look at an artifact domain here, this will be the main focus in the late game. But here, the level 3 is the first point. So, there's a percentage drop of a drop that is gold. So, you'll start to actually farm artifacts here, and this is where there's pretty much a guaranteed drop at 45. So, at pre-40, these are the only options you'll have. What I would say here, since the main focus will be other domains, to just farm enough to get attack percentage main stats on your artifacts and then just throw them onto your characters, level them up a little bit. Don't necessarily max out all the artifacts on every character because it will, in the end, be a waste of resources. But yeah, just get enough to get by, and again, attack main stats on your damage dealers, stuff like that. But definitely don't invest too much. The main focus and the main power boost you'll get early game is actually from the book domains. So we have one here, and there are a couple of other ones around the map depending on the book. But if we go here, if we look, all of these levels going into the late game, they all pretty much give the same books. The drop rate increases by very little. If we're really taking a look at this domain here, the books have probably the worst increase in drop rate of any domain. So it's actually beneficial to really farm these out in the early games since these will give you a good boost, since you'll be able to level up your talents with them. And the only time you actually start getting golds, and even at the last level, the drop rate is pretty horrible. So even here, your drop rate won't be that much higher than even the level 1 or a 2 here. Well, level 1 is probably much worse than level 2. So from 2 to the level 4 here, the increase is pretty bad. So I would say as soon as you do level 2, start doing that. Get the books done on all your characters, because once you do hit level 40 and 45, you don't necessarily want to be farming books when you could be farming for gold artifacts. It's not ideal, although it won't kill your game, obviously. It's just, I guess, more beneficial to farm the artifacts late game, because again, the drop rates are not that good to get actual good artifacts. It does take a long time. So wasting the least amount of resin late game on something that you could have farmed early game is definitely the way to go. And another one you'll be farming somewhat early game here, or actually you'll farm this pretty much throughout the whole time. But again, just like the books, the drop rate is pretty bad on these, like the drop rate increase, I mean. So as you go higher levels, the drops will get better. But even at the highest level, the gold basically never happens, and the purple is somewhat rare too. So you'll just be working with blues and greens even on the last level. So again, on level 2, you basically unlock the two that you're going to get pretty much the whole time. And yeah, when it comes to this domain, the blues and the greens are pretty much the only one you're going to be relying on. So farming the items here for your weapon ascensions and then farming the books is definitely going to be the way to go early game. You'll be able to, one, level up your weapon to max, and then you'll be able to get your books to level up your talents as high as possible. And if you know that you're going to be playing a character for a long time, before you even ascend to the next stage, I would just stockpile the resources you'll need for your weapon ascension and your books, because you'll know in advance what they'll be. So just stockpile those. So again, once you bridge the gap and go to level 40 and 45, you'll have those books and items stockpiled, so you don't, again, have to waste the resin. You could just fo put your full focus on artifacts, which is always the goal. Now, when it comes to domains, obviously there are different levels, and the increase in actual difficulty between the levels isn't too high at the beginning, so let's just take this one just to get the levels up here. Difference between level 1 and 2, actually the biggest difference will be on an artifact domain. So the difference between 1 and 2 here is not too bad. You could do it basically with very basic artifacts. Just throw on, I think like I mentioned at the beginning, the attack percentages on most of your things. Just throw those on, level them up a little, just enough to do it. Here, same thing. The biggest increase will come at level 40. So, power yourself enough. As soon as you hit 40, you want to power yourself enough to do these domains. If you can't, some people could play with a friend if you are able to duo the domain. It could make it easier if your friend is a little bit stronger than you, or if, even if you're both at the same level, then you could try to do the domain together. The drop rates are individual anyways, so duoing is always an option. But if you're going the solo route, you're going to want to try to, at this point, level 39 or 40, almost max out your domains, or bring it as close to possible to max as you can, so that you have the best chance possible of jumping right away onto this domain. 45, same thing. The gap in difficulty is quite big, so you want to try to get decent artifacts for that as well. But yeah, going on to the pre-40 artifacts, hopefully I have some down here. So as you can see, I farm mostly gold ones for now because I'm actually 55. But yeah, when we go into these artifacts here, the weakest ones will be the blue ones here. So you can see the base stat at level 1 is 430 to 645. The jump is pretty good. And if we look at a percentage one here, oh, we have two attacks here. So it goes from 5.2 to 6.3. That'll scale, and the difference will become bigger later on into the levels and the artifacts. But that's basically what you want to do. When you have blue artifacts, drop the blues onto your characters. So as soon as you get an attack percent, throw it on a character. And then as soon as you unlock, let's say, or drop a attack percentage purple, I would just replace that, upgrade your character again, and get yourself to the point where you can do the 40 artifact. Now, that's basically all there is to it in terms of early game domains. You want to focus on books and items. Artifacts, artifact farming early game is pretty much a waste. Just do it a very little to be able to get some. Buy yourself the time with those weaker artifacts to get yourself to the golds. Once you get to golds, go all out on them. That's really where you want to gather up all the artifacts, because that's the highest level you can get. And that pretty much wraps it up for the low-level domain guide. Again, this is solely focused on beginners, but if any of you did find it helpful, I would appreciate if you could subscribe to the channel, like the video, all that good stuff. And I'll be posting more beginner guides similar to this, just these lower-level concepts, just because I kind of wish I had them when I was initially grinding, so at the very early stages of the release.